I love how some of the progressives, the Young Turks sometimes, they talk about those interests. Who are all the billionaires putting all their money behind right now? Oh, Nikki Haley. Now, there are some people are switching over because they see what Trump is offering. But you have this huge establishment agenda to push forward Nikki Haley instead of President Trump.
Believe it or not, that was a Trump supporter who attended a Trump rally in New Hampshire. He was speaking to Michael Shore, and it's kind of surprising, right, to hear that he enjoys some of the things that TYT has to say, namely when we discuss topics pertaining to corruption of our political system and of our politicians. Now, you just heard his thoughts on Republican presidential candidate Nikki Haley. Let's hear what he has to say about Joe Biden.
And Biden, he can't claim to represent the people. He doesn't even show up and see them ever. He's literally just, everyone knows he's a puppet. He can't even walk, he can't even talk.
A puppet of whom?
All of the interests that I'm talking about. You know, you have these built-in interests within the administrative system. You can't get anything done in this country. We haven't built any nuclear. They're trying to shut down our energy. It's sad.
Shout out to nuclear, because I agree with him that we should shift to nuclear, at least in the short term, as we develop alternate forms of energy. I don't think that degrowth or, you know, living differently is a selling point for most Americans. They're not gonna wanna sign on to that. They're not gonna wanna change their lifestyles. Besides which, it forcing people to make individual changes to their lives, in my opinion, isn't gonna solve the problem. We do need a different way of providing energy that isn't dependent on fossil fuels, and nuclear energy is a clean energy source. But anyway, Cenk, I'm curious what you think before we get to the next video, because you know, his solutions for all of this, I definitely disagree with, but you know, yeah. It's interesting because I see a lot of this among, not all Trump supporters, don't get me wrong, but there is a portion of Trump supporters who have bought into his anti-corruption, drain the swamp messaging.
Yeah.
And they're concerned about a lot of the similar things that we're concerned about in our political system. It's just that they have this faith that Trump is gonna fix it, even though he didn't at all in the first term.
No, look, I gotta be honest, I love that interview. It confirmed so many of the things that I've told you 100 times on the show, right? So first of all, he was partly right, and a lot of MAGA is partly right, which they're really pissed about corruption. And when he, Michael, I'm really glad Michael followed up and said, who's the puppet? You know, who's he getting, who's controlling the puppet if Joe Biden's a puppet, right? And you could have had a lot of bad answers there. Right, and I've heard a lot of bad answers. Mm-hmm. And by the way, one of the most popular theories now is that Obama is secretly controlling Biden. But I do like that they switched up the racial stereotype so that black people are in charge of the whole country. Okay, so that's a nice twist, right? So, but yes, you hear a lot of folks say anti-Semitic things at that point, etc. But he said the correct thing, which is the donors. Well, and that's true. And so, but what he doesn't know is, but Donald Trump also takes money from donors. In fact, he took over $100 million from Sheldon Adelson twice, in 2016 and 2020.
Why might he not know that, Cenk?
Number one, because the Democrats never talk about it, because they also take donor money. So they voluntarily give up the best thing to say about Donald Trump, the thing that would convince most people that he's actually corrupt. And you look at the—
okay, but why else?
Okay. And media never wants to cover corruption, because almost all of that money goes to media in terms of ads. So media is never gonna talk about it, and Democrats are never gonna talk about it. Certainly the Republicans are never gonna talk about it, and right wing media isn't gonna talk about it. So that's why they never get the correct information. So that guy looks like he could actually get to the right place if he had all the info. So for on nuclear, he's not wrong. You know, that's an interesting debate. I'm not 100% sold in either direction. I think Anna makes compelling points there. But he then talks about how there's a kind of a little bit of a conspiracy against nuclear, coal and oil, etc., by the green energy folks. No, brother, there's oil subsidies to the tune of about $24 billion every year, where they take taxpayer money, they take your money, and give it to the richest people in the country who run oil companies when they don't need it at all. So if he had all the, and it's not all of MAGA, but a significant percentage of MAGA, if they had the correct information, would actually be on our side.
And look, the problem is, yes, like it's true that no one has perfect information. That is a growing problem in the country as we continuously exist in our own filter bubbles, as we get one narrative and one narrative only. I mean, let's just keep it real, guys. I mean, you're not even, if you work in political news, and this has become increasingly and abundantly clear to me, you have to pick a side and you have to constantly prove how pure you are in defending that one side. You're never allowed to point to the other side when they maybe make a good point. You're never allowed to, you know, deviate even a little bit from the predetermined default talking points on your political side. I know, because I experience it personally almost on a regular basis now. So think about the kind of media he's likely consuming. He's getting one side, and that one side consists of Donald Trump talking about draining the swamp, talking about how corruption is a problem. Now, does he actually want to do something about it? He had an opportunity, he didn't do something about it. He is one of the swamp monsters and always has been, as someone who inherited tremendous wealth from his papa. So with that said, what is this Trump supporter's solution as we barrel toward the 2024 general election? Let's watch.
The media has been freaking out because Donald Trump, he said that he's gonna be a dictator on day one and day one only. I love that. You know, I want a president who's gonna go in there and he's going to fix this situation. The executive government is supposed to represent the will of the people and who we elected, and we elected President Trump. So all of these people that are coming in the executive administration and cutting down him within his own cabinet, this is ridiculous. And a lot of these people need to be fired and replaced with loyalists like me, like him, like real patriots that are actually gonna represent this country and put our agenda forward to make America great again, period.
So he had 4 years to do that and you're saying he didn't. What makes you think differently this time?
Because this time we're gonna fire the people. Vivek came up with great plans and there's an effort, Project 2025. A lot of the liberals are freaking out about it. We're gonna go in the government, we're going to fire the administrative state that is within the executive branch that is elected by former presidents, both Republicans and Democrats, the establishment, the Bush Republicans, they have them locked in there. And then they cut down on the president and President Trump's agenda.
So a lot of what he said there was a little bit scary, okay? But I'm gonna focus on one main thing that he said. Which is the excuse that he has provided for why Trump failed to do what he promised to do in his first term. And it's this idea that his administration was stacked full to the brim with people against him, who were working against him and his agenda. And as a result of that, he was unable to accomplish what he had set out to accomplish. Obviously, that's not true. There are examples of people who are in Trump's administration who would hear him out as he proposed crazy things like, you know, doing a nuclear bomb on a hurricane or something, right? Like, yeah. And they would say, oh yeah, we got it, don't worry, we'll definitely carry that out. And then they would ignore it because it was lunacy, like you're not gonna do that. But the other thing that I get from that, Cenk, is honestly something I see on the left too. Once the person is set in supporting something or being against something, any excuse is good enough to provide cover for what they support, right? In this case, he loves Trump, he supports Trump. Trump failed in the first term to provide the, you know, agenda items that he purported to care so much about. But he'll find an excuse, his supporter will find an excuse. And in this case, the excuse is, well, he had people working against him in the administration.
Yeah, so there are two things about that. One is about that point. I actually think that he got super lucky because the establishment wound up providing just enough of a break in his car. So for example, and I can give you dozens of these examples. At one point in a meeting, he says, you know what, our nuclear stockpile, I want it to be 10x, 10 times what it is today. People are like, you have no idea how much that would cost. That would bankrupt the whole country, right? He's like, I don't care, get it done. And then they walk out of the meeting, Rex Tillerson, who was the Secretary of State at the time, says, what an effing idiot. And they all decide to ignore him because we don't have that money and you need Congress to pass it. He doesn't know anything, right? So they served as a break in his car so he couldn't get his mental things done that he wanted to do. And he loves being in charge unilaterally, i.e. dictator. That's why he talks about it, that's why they're excited about it. So next time though, there's not gonna be any breaks in the car. Next time is going to be an epic disaster. And so when it comes to this guy, it's not because he complimented us. Guys, you saw the clip there yourself. He's worried about corruption, and there's a second thing he's worried about. And you know how worried I am about that Trump actually becoming a dictator, right? But I realized watching this and all the other things that I looked at, oh, I get why they now have a negative view of democracy. I couldn't understand it because my whole life Republicans have been like, America, democracy, the Constitution. And now they hate democracy. That's so weird, right? And it's because they think democracy equals no action because of what our government has been doing for the last 40 years. Which is no action. And why do they do no action? Not because of democracy, but because the Supreme Court killed democracy by allowing open bribery and money in politics. So the status quo does not want anything to change because the people at the top are already at the top. They don't want to move from the top. That's why they instruct all of the politicians, do not change anything and keep us at the top. So now a giant section of the American people think, oh, democracy means we'd never get what we want. So why don't we try a dictator? Because he might do what we want and he could actually get it done. Now they'll regret that later. I mean, 222, I hope it never comes to that. But later they'll be like, well, I didn't know that it meant that he could just arrest anyone he wants or kill anyone he wants and that we were never gonna have another election. I thought we were electing a dictator. Now, a lot of them won't think that. They'll think, yes, we're back in charge. But a lot of guys like this are gonna be shocked to find out what a dictator actually means.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.